continue my discussion on rate of pressure rise. Okay, am I audible? Is it okay? Okay, see here, and we have taken three different conditions here. That means three cases here. Okay, so based on these three cases, we need to decide which one is perfect for us. Okay, so here, first of all, we are going to take the normal rate of combustion. Okay. Okay, here we are going to take three types of combustion rates. One is low rate, the second one is normal rate, and the third one is high rate. Okay, so when we are going to have low rate of combustion, okay, when the ignition advance is below the, that means if it is too early, okay, that means if the ignition advance is below the this optimum ignition condition, okay, so this is the start of pressure rise here, okay, this point is the start of pressure rise and this is the peak pressure, okay, for that cycle, this is the peak pressure which is going to be attained throughout the whole cycle, okay. So if the if we are going to have low rate, when we are going to have low rate means when the spark advance is too early or 30 degrees before TDC, okay, some below 30 degrees before TDC, that means up to around 35 degrees before TDC, if the spark, if we have initiated the spark 40 degrees TDC, then the start of pressure rise is going to be around 35 degrees before TDC. Okay, we have already seen, okay, the start of pressure rise, end of attaining its peak pressure during the combustion phases, right? So here the start of pressure rise is around 35 degrees before TDC, and here we are going to have low rate of combustion. Okay, why we are going to have low rate of combustion means, okay, so it has to, whatever the here the ignition is going to start before 35 degrees TDC, okay, right? But what is going to happen here, okay, so here whatever the combustion is happened, okay, there will be some combustion gases, okay, those combustion gases are going to will make the piston, okay, will make the piston hard to reach its top dead center, okay, in the normal case, okay, in normal rate of combustion or high rate of combustion, okay, so what is the main situation there, okay, so as it reaches the top dead center, after that the combustion gases are going to push the piston downwards, okay, but here if we initiate the spark too early, that means the start of pressure rise is too early, okay, so what is going to happen there, whatever the piston is there, that have to up throw the gases from the combustion products, okay, so the work input from the piston is should be heavier, okay, then only it can push the piston, that means it will become hard for the piston to reach TDC, okay, if we have initiated the spark here, okay, it will become for the piston to reach top dead center, so some of the work is going to be wasted here, okay, so because of that wastage of work, okay, some of the work is going to be wasted here. Why? Because here the piston has to do more work to push those or to compress those combusted gases. Why? Because it has to reach exactly, definitely it should reach the top dead center. Okay, but it is going to push the piston. That means whatever the combusted gases are there, because of this early combustion, these gases will oppose the piston to reach top dead center. Okay, so that's why the rate of combustion is going to be very low here. So that
सोनी नाही होता सोनी कॉम्बिनेशन अच्छा
ओके सी हियर in normal low rate of combustion, that's why we are going to have low rate of combustion when we have initiated the spark clearly. Why? Because it has to do some work against the piston, okay, what against these combustion gases, okay, the forces to oppose the forces from combustion products, okay, it has to. Okay, and because of that low rate of combustion, we are going to utilize some of the work in doing the work. That means piston work input is going to increase here. Okay, so that's why we are going to have low rate of combustion, and it is not at all sufficient for us. Okay, it is about the quarter, that means 40 degrees after TDC we are going to get the peak pressure here. Okay, so whatever the peak pressure is attained here, that is not sufficient for us. Okay, so that's why and the power is going to develop here almost the quarter of the expansion stroke, during the quarter of the expansion stroke, okay, which is not helpful for us to have some more work and breaking. Okay, sometimes there is network issues, that's why it is breaking. Okay, is it clear now? Okay, see here, if we have followed normal rate of combustion, then we are going to have sufficient power which can push the piston downwards easily, as well as it is not going to oppose the piston to reach the top dead center, and the pressure which is reduced is going to be in a linear way. Okay, so that it is the most recommendable case, which is a normal rate of combustion which we are going to follow. Okay, if you follow this normal rate of combustion, that means we are going to have no much tendency to knock. That means the knocking characteristics are going to be reduced, as well as there may be complete combustion. And here we are going to have high work output, as well as the power produced and efficiency increase. Okay, so that is what rate of pressurize, depending on rate of pressurize. If it is in a proper manner, okay, if the rate of combustion is going to be in a normal way, okay, we are going to have such high performance for the engine. Okay, and if it is high rate also, of course the power produced is high here, but it is going to be not in smoothness. Okay, if there is no smoothness, then the incomplete combustion we can see. Because of that incomplete combustion, there may be chances of knocking here. Okay, so we need to prefer the normal rate of combustion here. Okay, so next, moving to the knocking. Okay, knocking, which is an important characteristic when it comes to combustion. Okay, first of all, whenever we know about combustion, we definitely must know about the abnormal combustion or knocking. Here, abnormal combustion, knocking or detonation, all are same things. Okay, nothing but different names, like that only. Okay, so here abnormal combustion, knocking or detonation are the same here. Okay, first of all, what is knocking or abnormal combustion? Okay, coming to normal combustion. Okay, first of all, if we want to know about abnormal combustion, first of all, we need to know about the normal combustion. So what is normal combustion? Okay, when the flame travels evenly or uniformly across the combustion chamber. First, suppose when the piston is at top dead center or nearer to the top dead center. Okay, if the combustion is going to happen in a proper manner, that means if it is going to have only one flame front. Okay, so see here, we have only the flame front advancing towards the combustion chamber or piston head in a similar manner. Okay, here we have only one flame front here, that is from the spark plug. Whatever the combusted part is there, that is going to travel throughout the combustion chamber. Okay, in specific way, it is going, that means it is going to be in a uniform manner across the combustion chamber. This is the whole combustion chamber. Okay, so that is the normal combustion. And what is abnormal combustion here? Abnormal combustion means because of longer duration of running of engine. Okay, so there may be several hot spots. Hot spots means which are the regions which are going to be very hot. Okay, so because of running the engine for longer durations, okay, the intake or the exhaust valve, okay, and the piston head or the cylinder valves are going to be at very huge temperatures. Okay, so what happens here? Okay, whatever the unburned mixture is there, okay, whatever the unburned mixture is there, that unburned mixture is going to auto ignite itself, because it's it is going to reach its self ignition temperature because of these hot spots. If there are any hot spots there, okay, so these hot spots are going to auto ignite. Why? Because it is going to reach its self ignition temperature. So here we are going to have another flame print. Okay, if there is combustion is going to happen because of auto ignition temperature, and there is one flame print is going to travel from the spark plug. Okay, right? And here because of auto ignition and it since it is, it has reached its self ignition temperature, here we are going to have another flame front. So here because of hot spot here at the exhaust valve, since it is maintained at very high temperatures, there may be chances of having here auto ignition. That means this part of air fuel mixture, unburnt air fuel mixture, is going to be burnt because of reaching its self ignition temperature. So here another flame front is going to be propagated. So here, from here one flame front, from here one flame front, and from here another flame front. So there are several flame fronts we are going to categorize here. So because of production of these several flame fronts, what is going to happen? These are like clouds only. Okay, whenever two clouds are going to hit, what happens? There will be a thunder. Okay, that because of that lot of pressure difference, there will be a thunder. Similarly, here also, whenever these two flame fronts are going to collide each other, okay, there are lot of pressure differences are going to create here. Okay, because of that collision, there may be some vibrations in between these two different flame fronts. Okay, why? Because this flame front is going to be at one pressure and this flame front is going to be another at another pressure. So in different pressures are going to collide here. So whenever these are going to collide each other, what happens? There may be some creation of vibrations here. Okay, so once these vibrations are created, what happens? They will definitely transmit to the cylinder walls and the cylinder head. Okay, so nothing but, and also they can transmit to the piston also. Okay,